Okay, thanks for jumping in. Let's get started.
The other thing I wanted to quickly address was what is known as a URL. Basically, I'm just going to refresh this here so it'll be gone. Let's say we go to google.com. We'll notice that there is a URL, which is basically an acronym for the full term Uniform Resource Locator. And we say URL without even thinking what the actual meaning is. Over here, if you see this, it's HTTPS. This is what's known as a protocol. So you have different types of protocol. The S signifies that this protocol is secure, and you see so by the associated lock if you have a certificate or something like that to enforce the security. You could have a file protocol. You could have an HTTP protocol, the one that's not secure. You could have an FTP protocol. There's a bunch of protocols that you can set up here depending on what you're doing. Next, it's followed by the colon and two forward slashes, and then you get the host name. In our case, the host name is google.com. So the host name could be, you know, typed out. It could be an IP address. It could be numeric. So let's just open up terminal and let's just ping google.com. And we'll just grab this IP. So I could replace the host name right in here with the actual IP. So here it is. Now, if I hit enter, it should bring me back to the exact same page. Now, because this is a private connection, we're gonna go advanced and we're say continue. We're at the same page. Just this one's in dark mode because of the time of the day.
What do you mean I left the video on? Oh, snap. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna get back to work. And you guys get back to the video. Okay, they're still there. All right, I'm going.
But what's next is the forward slash, and then we usually have some kind of path. So usually you could have a path that leads to something or a slug that's identified by, you know, two words or more than one word joined together with an underscore or just a single word by itself, depending on how you have your slug set up. And you may have a query, so this question mark, and then you have, you know, an actual query string with some parameters or something specific with a pound sign. So this is what is after the host name. It's the path. The last thing that you may find or see in a URL is you will find the file name. Let's take a look at that over here. As you can see, I put the file name in here, and the file name in our case is index.html. If I was to remove this, it still takes us to the same place. If I place the file name back in, it's still the same thing. On our project, it's referencing the index.html. Just note that you could have a different file extension. You know, this could be PHP. If I type this in right now, this won't work. I'll get an error or a status error 404 not found, but it could be .pdf. It could be something else. Whatever the URL is pointing to or giving the path to with the file name or extension, this is where it would lead to. This stuff starts coming in handy when we start to take a look at links and sources and different ways to point to a path or a URL. So I want you to keep that in mind just to know what that is and what it's actually doing. If you're already aware of that, that's perfect. I mean, we use URLs all the time, shorten ones, we modify them, all sorts of things. Now, don't get that confused with a URI. That's something completely different entirely. But a URL is the Uniform Resource Locator, and the URI is the Uniform Resource Identifier. So if you really want to get kind of technical, I guess you could say a URI is a name just by itself, or a name with a protocol that tells you how to reach it, and that's a URL. So it's kind of a subset of a URL. You guys can research that on your own time, but as long as you got the basics, I think you should be okay. So in summary, this will help you for the rest of the videos moving forward when we start talking about tags and attributes, and I'll cover some stuff around the boilerplate in a future video, but the URL and the URI, we won't touch too much on that. There will be certain elements that will have a URL or a source, and you will need to kind of be familiar with that if you want to navigate through folders, whether they're absolute paths or relative paths. This stuff does kind of make sense if you understand how it's set up and why it's doing what it's doing. And with that, I will see you guys next time. And that's it for this one, guys. Don't forget to like the video if you found this useful. Leave your comments and thoughts below. Take care, and I will see you next time.